Because I don't want to explain much because I am here only to extend our greetings to AFRT. This is Dharna on behalf of CPML Raksha. We know that there is a paradigmatic shift in education and the whole educational policy. And we know that education is inseparable. It is intertwined with the material and ideological basis of the ruling system. So over the years, if we examine, during the welfare state period, that is during the Nehruvian period, we know Kothari Commission. That at that time we had a policy that stood for state-led education, public education. And the Kothari Commission suggested that 6% of the GDP should be spent for education. It was based on the understanding in many countries, even in imperialist countries, 6% of the GDP is set apart for education. So Kothari Commission suggested. But when we come to the 80s, it was not implemented. But when we come to the 80s, what happened? Neoliberalism came. Welfare state collapsed. Nehruvian policies were slowly abandoned. And a new education policy during the Rajiv regime came. We started this privatization. All these agenda were started. Then in the 90s we saw, during Vajpayee regime, when the second generation of globalization, during the Vajpayee regime started, Ambari Birla report came, private universities came. So a gradual shift is there. Now today, when Modi came, this neoliberal, far-right neoliberalism today, and in accordance with the fascist agenda of RSS, under this neo-fascist regime, what we are experiencing today is a corporatization along with the suffragization. So corporatization, suffragization of education, that is going on today. And we must know that today at the global level, education is becoming privatized. Private capital, internationalization of capital, private universities are coming. We know that in IIT in India, if on an average 2 lakh rupees is the fee per year, when private universities, foreign universities are coming, it will be 20 lakh. Foreign universities means 20 lakh rupees will be the average price. This is the situation. On the one hand, from the 1980s onward, when the new education policy of the Congress government came into being, there was a slogan, education for all. The content of that education for all was informalization of common education. So the whole education was becoming informalized for the common people. For the upper caste, for the upper elite, the elitization of education took place. I am not explaining those details. Today we are seeing a situation where the whole education system is corporatized. Corporate capital have full control along with the role of sovereign forces in educational field. Today, Hindu mythology, if you go to the new education policy, NEP, you will see the RSS organizations, they clearly stated 80% of our suggestions have been incorporated. Vidya Bharati, similar such RSS organizations, they have openly claimed that 80% of our suggestions have been incorporated into NEP 2020, approved by the cabinet in July 2020. While 2 lakh recommendations were there from progressive sections, students, organizations, teachers, organizations, and like-minded people, 2 lakh recommendations, none of these recommendations were incorporated into the NEP. So it is purely based on Hindutva agenda. And now Hindu mythology is incorporated into education. Whatever connected with Islamic tradition in India, we must know we have a long tradition of Islamic culture in India. Nothing is there. It is excluded. You see, There is foreign languages, a list of foreign languages, Spanish, many Arabic, these are Japanese, Korean, Russian, and many foreign languages are there. But Arabic is specifically excluded. 65 lakh of Indians are working in Gulf countries where the language is Arabic. It is excluded. I am not going into details. I want to expose by saying one thing. You know why Mandarin was included in the draft policy? Mandarin was there in the draft policy of this new education. Why? During the period when Modi's visa was denied, America denied Modi's visa as a result of the Gujarat pogrom. Then Modi established his contact with the Chinese imperialism. And because of his close intimacy, Chinese, this Ahmedabad University, Vadodara University, their Mandarin was started. And in the new education policy, Mandarin, the draft Mandarin was incorporated. But when the new education policy was adopted in 2020, border question came. China penetrated, invaded. What happened? Mandarin was excluded. This is what is going on. So it is a totally, it is not in accordance with the country's interest. It is our corporate capital. It is our Hindutva process. Now there is no mention of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Socially and economically disadvantaged groups. Only that is the answer. Only socially and economically disadvantaged groups mentioned. No mention of SEs and SGs. So it is against the vast majority of the oppressed people. And it is with that perspective, these economic reservation and all our things are being brought into the picture. Comrades and friends, we must resist it. We must defeat it. There should not be any compromise for this new education policy because it is intertwined with, inseparable from the economic, political, cultural and all aspects of the Hindutva regime, the corporate servant agenda that is behind the new education policy. No doubt, we have to reject it. We have to oppose it at any cost. Thank you. Red salute from CPM and Red Sir.